Hello, this is Blue Diamond Coasters, and if you couldn't tell by the rubber ducky fountain behind me, we're here at Six Flags Great Adventure. This is my second visit of the season so far, but this will be your first.
That's right.
And we're just here to have a fun day. Nitro's finally reopened, same with Batman, and then we get to just experience Kingda Ka and all the other great rides of the park. Fortunately, Toro and Medusa are still closed for maintenance and other just staffing work, but we'll be heading over to Kingda Ka really soon and get our first ride today on that.
And as I was finishing that up, I see the massive crowd coming this way because we actually got in a few minutes early, like about like 10 minutes early,
yeah.
Because we used the diamond priority entrance over there.
Thanks to these things.
Well, yeah, so you're a
that
member.
That was for me.
So my interesting story, I originally wasn't planning on getting a pass for this year just because I was going to be working at Hershey over the summer and they get a pass for me there. So I wasn't really planning on getting one. But my grandma actually got me the Platinum Pass, which is the kind of like the medium tier one, and so for Christmas. And so I thought, all right, might as well just spend the $50 to upgrade to the full, which gives me benefits like that entrance over there, as well as four skip-a-lines for the season, which I may or may not use here. Over here's a view you don't normally see. These doors just wide open on both sides. I guess they're like bringing trucks and stuff here, but I guess this is an uncommon angle of Green Lantern. And it still looks like garbage from over here.
Well, Intamin's pulling an Intamin, and it's down. So, I realized, so I already bought the locker, but then, so what we're doing is we took our stuff out, and it still should be good for 2 hours. So, hopefully that'll reopen in 2 hours when we go back. And also, Zoom and Jaws closed, and everything pretty much on this half the park is closed. So that leaves us with Superman and
Green Lantern.
Yeah, so it was a few days ago, we were talking on our group chat with David, Amanda, Gabe, all of them. And I was saying about how Green Lantern is terrible. So, but they convinced me that I should give it another chance.
Is this like your third chance?
Kind of. I mean, I haven't done it since Holiday in the Park 2021.
That was the last time I did it too.
So, I mean, last time I was here for opening day, I went into the station for Green Lantern and then just walked straight through. So, I guess I'll give it another shot, and I don't know, I have to ask someone what the method is or whatever.
I think the method is just survive, honestly.
Well, no, the method is don't ride. That's the method to not, if you don't want to be hurt by Green Lantern, don't ride.
Don't ride Green Lantern.
Yeah. But I think we'll start off with Superman, which I don't think I've ever done my first ride of the day as Superman, but we'll see how it goes.
Actually, that was really fun. I'm used to doing Superman in the back row.
Me too.
And I'm used to like being thrown going into the pretzel loop, but in the front row, you kind of feel like getting thrown going out.
Yeah, like coming out of the pretzel loop, it's really forceful.
Yeah. And unfortunately, Kingda Ka is still down, and I've kind of been peer pressured, so...
We doing it again!
I'm doing Green Lantern.
I don't wanna, but I kind of have to. I know I've said in the past that if you ever see me on Green Lantern, that I'm doing against my will, and that's not me. Well, I am doing this against my will, and this fortunately is me, so... Let's get on. Thank you. Why couldn't you be fixed and reopened? Now I have to do this. Thanks, Ka. Now I'm gonna have a headache for the next few hours. Okay, I did Green Lantern again. It's been a while. And I did the method where you kind of like bend your knees at first, let the restraint come down, and then kind of go put your shoulders up into it. So that does help the ball busting problem. Thing is, I think after that ride, this ride should be rethemed from Green Lantern Professor Xavier from X-Men, because I need a goddamn wheelchair, because my legs are jelly. So this ride got a bit better. On like,
does it move up in your rankings?
No, I don't think so. I might have to think about that. I don't know. Maybe once I ride like one of the lairs, that might take its spot.
I know, but my positioning on that ride, they told me to stand up, and they like put it the bicycle seat up all the way.
Yeah. I kind of like so pushed mine down a bit.
I was in the middle, so I just had one foot on that like yellow middle part.
I didn't put mine.
That helped a bit. Still not my favorite ride though.
No, I hate it. It's bad. It's probably still probably just my least favorite just for because it's always been my least favorite. And I kind of want to keep it that way. But nah. But now that I know I guess the defensive method, I can ride it again. So I can give it other chances. I still hate it. But it's now at least I can at least ride it without feeling immense pain. Like I still got a bit of headbanging, but not a whole lot. It's just that I need a goddamn wheelchair. Well, Kingda Ka is still closed after all this time. But Zubanjaro is open, so we'll head back and do that maybe a few times. Just so we can make up for walking all the way back here. And also, we noticed while we're on Green Lantern and just kind of watching it, Nitro hasn't ran at all today. So that makes three of the big four coasters down. Yay. Hey, Cam, can you get Nitro open, please? Thank you. That's some good news. I was about to say, you know, we can ride this a few times and see if we get a duel with Ka. But maybe we will. Oh! It rolled back! The one time I actually filmed it, it rolled back. Yay!
It's the catch car. So I think I see the problem. This is the one we were sitting in. Yeah, by the way, Zubanjaro went down. Just saw Kingda Ka roll back. Typical Great Adventure Day. But it looks like this car is the one having the problem. The catch car isn't locking up. Would have been awkward if all the other cars went up and we were still sitting here when it went. We also noticed while we were just hanging up there, the wind is very high, so this might be a pretty big day for rollbacks and a very bad day for if you actually want to ride Kingda Ka. And we also saw, just by looking at the app and us just watching it, Nitro hasn't sent a train yet.
Yeah,
and we also looked on the app, Dark Knight is down. So this is a very Six Flags day we're having today.
I'd say so.
Quintessential Six Flags day.
Thanks, Salim.
Yep. But we're gonna probably get something to eat right about now because I haven't eaten yet and I'm hungry and thirsty. So we went through Wild Walkway. A lot of the animals just weren't there, but you know what? Let's go ride El Toro. Oh, yeah, that whole area is still closed. Okay, maybe we could do, you know, it's a warm day out. Let's do Log Flume. Maybe then we could do Medusa. Oh yeah, that area is closed off too.
What's around here?
Nothing. Yeah, they can get your the iconic photo that everybody has of Great Adventure. Yeah, you can get a photo of three closed rides. Four closed, well, Zoo and Jaws now are back open, but three closed coasters all in one shot. Yep, here you can see three closed coasters. One, two, three, and maybe somewhere over there behind that building is four closed coasters all right here. Six Flags Day! So Sean decided to get a burger. He's getting his burger now. I'm over here at Cheesesteak. We got a cheesesteak with raw cheese. Well, one thing I do like about this place is all the boardwalk pictures on the wall, including around the corner over there is one of Disney's boardwalks, so that's kind of cool to see that there's a bit of Disney in Six Flags.
Alright, lunch was very filling. The guy like loaded the cheese. You just had it. How was your cheeseburger?
It was good actually. Better than the last one that I had at Garden State Grill.
Yeah, I remember that. They just kind of slapped a cold piece of cheese on a hamburger. But we were going to start heading towards the other side of the park. Then we saw Ka, we just sailed. And it's over. Yep, Ka is sending some test trains, so we'll be heading over there. I think the biggest problem today with Ka is just going to be the wind. It's going to be having a problem getting it over.
I know it's saying it's going to rain a bit later, but that's going to be once the park closes.
Yeah.
So probably not later right now.
Man, wind at Great Adventure? I don't have any experience in that in the past month.
We all made it to Taco Bell. We are hunkering down in the storm. It just...
But yeah, hopefully Kyle will reopen soon and we'll actually, or not even reopen, just open. It hasn't even opened up today. So hopefully we'll be getting on it soon.
So, after like God knows how long of waiting for this thing to open, we finally got on Ka. Not just that, Sean here got his first front row ride on Ka.
I did. I loved it. Yeah, it was really good. Fun. Really incredible. I loved the speed. It felt a bit smoother. The views, obviously.
Yeah.
It was great.
Yeah, I feel like I've been on front row in here before, but it's been a while. By the way, we are now actually joined by our good friend Draven.
Hello.
AKA
Launch Fanatic.
Yep, Launch Fanatic. You were kind of in the background of one of my previous videos back at Hershey, but I don't think you're actually in it.
Oh no.
Yeah. That was the day you like walked into Hershey, saw the crowds, and immediately turned back around. So.
I've done that a lot.
Yeah. But anyway, we're now gonna be heading over to that side of the park. For us, it'll be our first time over like that side of the fountain. I think we're gonna be heading to Justice League next. So I did pretty good, 162,000. Sean had a good face, but no score. We're over here now at Dark Knight, and for the first time since before COVID, they're actually using a pre-show.
Too bad they're leaving the doors open during the pre-show, defeating the entire purpose of it.
You had one job, Salim.
The whole point of the pre-show is that you need to escape by taking the subway. Why don't you just escape through those doors?
Yes. Also, Back to the Future music. Music from a much better themed ride. Please bring it back. So they're running the pre-show, but they're just letting people walk through. Plus, I guess it's optional. Employee banged this door with a hammer. It's like completely just indented in now. Alright, we just did front row on Dark Knight Coaster. That's still pretty good. We noticed one weird, like there's this big like headlight that was kind of like shining on the side of the building. We could pretty much see it from the entire ride.
Some effect I didn't remember.
Yeah. Although I think after riding this and Hershey's Wild Mouse, like back-to-back weekends, I feel like I prefer Hershey's Wild Mouse a bit more
now. Well, I've always preferred that Wild Mouse,
yeah.
But...
we're still pretty close, though.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't know exactly what we're going to do next, because the line for Batman looks pretty long, but...
skip the line.
I don't want to waste mine on Batman at my home park. But hopefully we'll be riding something pretty soon, probably either this or Jersey Devil.
Well, we didn't do Batman or Jersey Devil, but we are here on Skull Mountain, waiting for the best row, the back row. Hopefully they made sure to close all the doors and windows this time, so that way it's actually, you know, dark in here. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I've always wanted to do this at night, just to make sure that it's actually dark. But, looking forward to a good intimate ride.
All clear? Hopefully you guys are out here to clear eyes Skull Mountain.
Alright, we just did Skull Mountain. By the way, one interesting thing they're doing now, they have these, like, fences here, and now you have to, like, walk through the gift shop here. But the ride overall was really fun. I got, like, a ton of room on the back.
Get pranked.
I fell for it, too.
I mean, I didn't fall for it, but I'd followed a bit. Anyway, by the way, you can also see over there, there's Barnstormer. Taking its sweet ass time.
Such fun vehicles.
So we got a bit of a closer look over here at Barnstormer, and there's literally like nothing. Like I could just walk in here, go right up to the vehicles. Right here is the operator booth. Here you go. How many times a day do you think like a little kid walks over and tries to get in?
Sorry, Alex is here.
Oh, where is he? There he is. Yeah. Well, you just got here. Look at this. We can just walk right into Barnstormer.
Really?
Yeah.
You go right in.
Yeah, don't get too close. But, yeah.
You step over this line, you get banged.
don't cross this line or I will kill you. But anyway, yeah, hopefully this will reopen soon.
Thing is weird. I kind of laughed. Gangnam Style started playing. What is this? 2012. But I decided for one thing, first time I'm ever having a churro at Six Flags. I've kind of over the past year or so gotten more into churros because before then I didn't really like them a whole lot just because I wasn't a cinnamon fan. But at my job at the movie theater, we sell churros, and I started to eat them while I was working. Like I would make some for myself, or if ever no one grabbed any, I would grab some. And I started to really like them, so I'm gonna be trying some more at different parks over the year.
You gotta try a lot more cinnamon-based snacks, like cinnamon pretzels, cinnamon. Well, you already like cinnamon bread.
Yeah. I think also Dollywood cinnamon bread helped out with getting my love of cinnamon. I don't know. I still prefer regular applesauce to cinnamon applesauce, though. But I'll see how this turns.
All right, time for a taste reaction. Definitely loaded with cinnamon. I think I prefer the ones at my theater though. I think those are like smaller and those are like fresh out of the oven especially, they're really good. So we probably go on Jersey Devil in a bit, but meantime we're over here by Nitro, which has been closed all day. It was one of the reasons we came here too, because this was closed during opening weekend because they were busy putting on the new train, and then they did reopen it and then they closed it again. Although we saw they posted earlier like it's National Hiring Week, come join our ride op team, and they posted a picture of a bunch of ride ops on the lift hill. I'm like, come on, just teasing us here. But yeah, really wish this was open. Candemonium and Diamondback are better. Kind of see through there the new totally not Sky Rush trains. It's like, hey mom, can we ride Sky Rush trains? Oh no honey, we have Sky Rush trains at home. And there they are. I bet you like Grave Avenger's like, hey Hershey, can we just borrow some blue paint? We might have some red paint in the back you can use for Wildcat. There you go. But yeah, wish it was open, but I'll be back here later in the season anyway to go ride it.
We're waiting for Jersey Devil to go, but Alex here pointed out something. So there's the El Diablo Jersey Devil statue, and over here is Sane from Smiling Friends. Yeah, I definitely see it.
Coincidence? I don't think so.
Can Gilbert Gottfried come down and save this ride?
I think he can.
Deal's a deal! Quickly, Charlie, get on!
Blast foiled again!
Thank you, Cam, for not stapling me. Now can you please go open Nitro?
So that does it for us here at Six Flags Great Adventure. We're heading out a bit early just because, if you see my last video here, you know I have experience with great adventure and storms, and there's a storm on our way, so we're gonna head out a bit early to maybe beat that. But overall, this was definitely a Six Flags day.
Certainly was.
Nitro was closed all day, Toro is still closed, Medusa is still closed, Ka was temperamental, Jersey Devil was Jersey Devil, Batman had a really long line, a lot of other things were really long line. It's just a Six Flags day overall, so
yeah.
I still had fun. I still had some good moments. I got a slightly better ride on Green Lantern. Not saying much, but slightly better than the last time. Anything you guys want to add?
Front row on Ka for me.
Oh, yeah, that was fun. A big deal. That was fun.
You have to do a front row. I'm hoping to get that next time.
Next time, for sure. You should try it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was average day, average Six Flags day. Things definitely could have gone better, especially with Nitro being closed. That was a shame.
Yeah.
Next time probably coming in summer when everything will hopefully be open, and yeah, hope to have a better experience.
I'll probably come back a few times over the summer as well.
Yeah, I'm probably not coming back until El Toro.
Well, yeah, I think that's the summer, so
that's yeah.
As soon as El Toro gets announced, I'm going to post on my Instagram when I'm coming.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
If you want to come one. Hang out, hit me up. I launch that.
Yeah.
So
just to wrap things up, make sure you do the usual. Like, comment, subscribe. Make sure you also follow at Blue Diamond Coasters on both Instagram and TikTok.
Follow me on YouTube and Instagram, East Coaster Fan.
This Launch Fanatic on Instagram.
He left us a little while ago, but make sure to also follow Alex at Alex Studios.
And also follow Cam at
I was about to say, at Hyper Thrills.
Hyper Thrills.
Yeah.
Sorry, Cam.
Yeah. Wish you could be here. You're busy stapling people under his devil.
That's right. My ride hurt. Yeah.
So, this is Blue Diamond Coasters.
This is the East Coaster Fan.
Launch Fanatic.
Later.